Welcome. I'll do a cold start on my 2011 Dodge Ram 1500. Take a little look around it. It's a little dirty over in the Pacific Northwest. We've had some rainy, stormy weather. So it's kind of a little bit dirty. But it's a 2011 4x4. It's got the 4.7. It's got the 4.7 liter tow package. It's the ST model with the convenience package. And we'll see what happens. We were right around 30 degrees last night, give or take. And we'll see what happens. A little dirty for a truck, but we'll see what happens. It's got 8,396 miles on it. Take a look around. That's pretty much basically a standard model. I have a video of when I first got it, but it's basically a pretty much a standard model. Not a bad truck though, really. Not a bad truck for the price. Let's fire her up. Perfect. Nothing beats the modern day EFI systems, really. I mean, you start up an old truck with a carburetor, and I mean, some of the newer carburetors work pretty good, but some of the older stuff takes a long time for it to start up and warm up. Especially, I've noticed Fords were a little bit more cold-blooded than Chevrolets on their original carb. On our 1986, we switched the carburetor from a Holley to an Edelbrock, and it seems to work a lot better than the Holley did. But nothing beats the computerized stuff where they fire up. And current temperature is 45 degrees out, and it's not freezing. Definitely not warm. Click the motor open here. Let's show that. Got a little bit of leaves I have to clean out. But it's the 4.7 liter. It's the dual spark plugs, so it's got 616 spark plugs on it. It's been a pretty good motor, really. I haven't had too much problems with it. It does knock a little bit when it first starts up, but I was told that's normal. I don't quite believe it, but I had a big old fight with Dodge about it, with a Chrysler about it, and they swear it's normal, so we'll see. To me, it's got a weak oil pump, but they say it's normal, so we'll go ahead and take their word for it. I personally don't think it is, but whatever. Other than that, that's really about it. As you can see, Dodge changed a whole lot when you open it up here. They made it to where they just have the hood open instead of the whole entire thing opening up. They changed that. They didn't really update the 5. I think they updated the 5.7 Hemi VV8. I know they did. They redid the heads on the 4.7 to add a little bit more power to them. This one does not have. Correct me if I'm wrong, but this one does not have the cylinder deactivation system. I know the Hemi does, but this one does not. And actually, gas mileage between the two is not that far off. I mean, I personally, after getting the 4.7 versus the 5.7, I would recommend, if you guys buy this truck, to get the 5.7. Because the gas mileage in between the two motors is only like a couple gallons. It's not really worth the extra, you save $1,000. I mean, it's not really worth it. By the time you put the payment in, and if you're doing a down payment, the math all just works out to be a lot better. I was bought it at Northwest Jeep Chrysler Dodge. Pretty good dealership. One of the better ones around for the Pacific North and North Northwest. And that's really about it. Looks like it's running quite good. Not a bad 4x4 either, actually. For standard, it's not that bad. Got the job done. Well, I guess I will see y'all later. Have a good one. Bye.